everybody. It's Anna. Welcome to the Thursday card in this week's tarot story. So today we have the Nine of Pentacles. Pentacles are connected to the physical realm. So they're about things you can see and taste and touch, your physical resources and physical wellness and vitality. And the number nine is the step just before the 10, which is the completion of our journey. So this is the moment just before you cross the finish line. The image here shows a woman who's dressed in this beautiful gown. She's in this abundant garden, which she has planted and planned and has created with the, in partnership with the universe. So she's taking some time here to just enjoy the fruits of her labor, right? The things that she has manifested in the physical plane. And this is a receptive moment in the tarot journey. So I talk about active steps and resting steps. Well, the resting steps are connected to the feminine principle of spirituality because we're not taking action, we're receiving action. We're being open and receptive and hospitable, right? So she's taking a time to let herself be filled, to receive the gift of what she has created. And this is just before the 10 point, as I said, where this gift suddenly goes into the world. So once you get to the 10 point, it doesn't belong to you anymore. What you've been creating, you release to others and you start something over. So this is your last chance to really let yourself enjoy and be filled up with your own magic, the evidence of your own magic. And I think this is really interesting. This is the third card we've had this week, which is about the feminine principle of spirituality. It's about not taking action, but pausing, receiving, being open, basically letting yourself be filled up. This is the point where we are nurtured in our journey. That's why it's important not to skip these points, right? It's really easy to forget about them, especially in the world we have, which is very linearly focused, right? Which is all about take A, B, C, D. These are all your action steps. And we sort of forget there's any pause between the action steps. And a lot of people will do things that way. They'll just take a dozen action steps in a row and they never pause to allow the integration of the steps. And that might work for some systems. Like if you have a system that's already set up, you're not really surfacing magic or really creating new things, you're repeating patterns, then you can probably take multiple action steps in a row, right? But if you're creating something, if you're evoking new things, if you're manifesting something new, then you're working with magic. You're working in concert with the universe. And that means you have to take a pause. You take a step, the universe takes a step. And when the universe takes a step, you rest and you get yourself nurtured. You're restored by that moment. Because if you don't, it's not sustainable. You don't have the nurture to continue your journey and you burn out eventually. So this card invites us to be in the world, to recognize what we have done, to really savor it and enjoy it. And I think this is so important. This is just the message we keep getting, is that you can't just be acting in the world. You can't just be giving. You have to also receive. You have to get good at that. And most of us are better at receiving one or the other. We're either better at receiving or we're better at giving, right? And most of my clients are bad at receiving, and I'm also one of those people. So it really is a challenge. You have to get better at receiving. It is a growing edge that you cannot neglect. If you neglect it, you're going to keep getting stuck. Somewhere down the road, you're going to sabotage yourself. You're going to run out of gas. You know, you won't be able to cross the finish line because you're only doing half of the work. Half of the work is not working at all. It is resting. It is letting yourself enjoy the garden. So consider what you have created in your life, and are you giving yourself room to pause, to enjoy it, to settle into it? And if not, why not? What is blocking you from letting yourself be filled and nurtured by the manifestations you've already brought into the planet? That's our today's card. See you tomorrow for our final one. Bye.